Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, what up? Today I'm bringing you guys my winter favorites. This is just going to be a wrap up of all of the products that I have been loving for this season. That's going to include home fragrance products, body care, and makeup. So it's a ton of stuff. Like literally, you guys, it's a ton of stuff. It's all sitting behind me on the bed. And I'm going to go through the items pretty quick because I don't want this video to be too long. If you guys want to check out any of my other favorites videos that I did, I will have them linked up in the cards for you to go and check out. I did a fall favorites part 1 and 2. And my winter favorites will also be part 1 and 2, just because I always have a bajillion things to talk about. But with that being said, let's jump right in, you guys. Okay, so we're gonna start with candles. 3 of them are pretty much all the way burned, for real, you guys. But yeah, peppermint sugar cookie. So I have 2 of these, and basically, like I told you guys, I did a mint themed Christmas this year. So pretty much a lot of the candles that I've been burning in my house have some type of mint theme to them, the color and the wax or the smell. So peppermint sugar cookie, this is literally like one of my all-time favorite holiday scents. It's just a perfect blend of peppermint and buttery sugar cookie. Love it so much. So I was able to go through 2 of these candles, and I still have 2 more. It's an absolute favorite. I love it. I could not wait until the winter time to actually start burning these. So I'm obsessed. Another candle that I'm obsessed with, this is Twisted Peppermint, and it's just inside of a candle holder. This I have been burning in my room. I love Twisted Peppermint. Every year I need one during the winter season because it's just so nice to burn in your house when you're feeling really stuffy, or maybe you've had the heater on all day and it's kind of warm in your house. This gives a nice cooling, almost aromatherapy type vibe, but it still has a little bit of sweetness as well because it's not just straight up peppermint. It has some sugar in there, it has some vanilla as well. So it's just a really nice candle to burn during the winter time just to kind of give you an uplifting mood. And then the last candle I have here is Red Velvet Cupcake. I've talked to you guys about this one already. This is an absolute love, an absolute favorite. I was going to stock up on this candle when they had the $12.95 sale, I believe, but I decided not to get any more candles because I have a ton that I need to get through. But this is definitely a favorite, highly recommended. Some people have had trouble with burning theirs. Mine has been amazing, a perfect burn all the way down, very clean, not sooty at all. It definitely gives off a lot of scent. I use it in my bedroom, and my bedroom is not huge, but it's not small either, and I feel like this fills my entire bedroom, into my bathroom and into the hallway as well. So it's just a really nice burning candle. It smells like chocolate cake and cream cheese frosting. It is amazing. So it's definitely been a favorite. So let's move on to some body care. I really have a lot of body care items to talk to you guys about, most of them being from Bath & Body Works, of course, but let's start off with the ones that I got from Target and Walmart. So this is the Native Sugar Cookie Body Wash. You guys should already be familiar with this one. So many people have been hyping this body wash up. It smells like sugar cookies. I've said it before, to me it smells like peanut butter sugar cookies, and I love peanut butter cookies. So this has definitely been good in the shower. I use it with any of my like gourmand scented routines, and I feel like it just adds a nice touch to it. I have another one of these, so you guys will probably be seeing one in my empties, and then I will have another one on backup that I will probably save for next holiday season, but I don't know, we'll see. I might not be able to save it. I might have to start using it, but this is a really nice body wash. I do feel like the Native body washes lather nicely and they get you clean, but I just love it for the scent, really. Next is going to be my Vaseline Intensive Care Almond Smooth Lotion. I've mentioned this one as well. This was in my winter body care essentials favorites, and basically this is just such a good generic lotion to use as soon as you get out of the shower. This is really going to give you the moisture on your skin that you need. It has Vaseline jelly droplets in it, so it's thoroughly moisturizing. It's going to coat your skin really, really nicely and give you that hydration. And I say all the time, these lotions are the best to use on your skin before you go in with your scented lotions, because they actually do a really good job of healing your dry skin and soothing your dry skin and correcting your dry skin, whereas the scented lotions really are mostly for the scent. I know that they have some good ingredients in there, but they're mostly for the scent. These are the lotions that are really going to heal your skin. So love this one. Love using it fresh out of the shower. It has a nice kind of almond clean Vaseline scent to it. It's nothing too heavy. It's not going to interfere with your fragrances, so it's just really nice to use it every single day. For actual body care, there's so much, you guys, so let's get into it. The first thing I want to talk to you guys about is the Twisted Peppermint 24-hour Moisture Cloud Body Butter. Yes, I did just get this at the Body Care Day sale, and I really feel like I'm going to end up using this up, you guys, because for one, I definitely have been feeling a little bit stuffy. I definitely have been needing something to kind of open up my sinuses and things like that, so I've been using a lot of peppermint products, a lot of peppermint soothing items in the the shower, and this has definitely been doing it for me, you guys. It gives the most cooling menthol sensation on your skin when you use this immediately out of the shower. You feel cool for like the next 10, 15, 20 minutes. It feels so good, and this is definitely moisturizing. All I put on today after getting out of the shower was this body butter, and I do not feel itchy or dry or anything at all today. Like I said, I was just going for something kind of simple and pepperminty because I haven't been feeling too well. This is amazing. This did the job for me. I absolutely love this. Y'all could probably expect to see this in an empties video coming up soon because I don't think that I am going to save this for the summertime. Like I said, if I can get another one at SAS, then I'll have that one for the summertime. But for this one, I don't think I'm going to make it the summer for that one because I think I'm going to use it up quick. Some more body care products that really took me by surprise that I really didn't expect to love as much as I do. But you guys are going to see right now, I have put a dent in these products because I absolutely love this scent and I did not think that I would love it as much. And that is Hope Winter Peach Marshmallow. So this one, I loved it when I first smelled it, but I didn't know that I was going to be that in love with it when I started using it. So you guys can see how much of the mist I've used already. I only used this like a couple of days in a row and I put that big of a dent in it. This smells so good. The lotion is a quarter of the way gone. This is so good, you guys. This smells just clean, but it's very sweet. It's very vanilla. It does have this creaminess to it. It says creamy jasmine, vanilla meringue. It does have a creaminess to it. This doesn't actually have marshmallow in it, but you guys, something about this is just fluffy, wintry, clean, fruity, fresh, pretty. It's all of the things, you guys. This smells amazingly good. I have absolutely been loving this body care set, and I did not think that I would love it as much as I do. But I highly recommend Hope Winter Peach Marshmallow, and if I see it at SAS, I'm definitely grabbing a backup, period. Joy Sugar Snickerdoodle, you guys already know about this scent. I don't have to tell you too much about it. Y'all see how much of my mist I've already used. The lotion is halfway gone. It just is a favorite. I keep coming back to this one. I keep gravitating towards it. It's one of my favorite gourmand scents, period. Like, it's literally up there in like my top three gourmand favorite scents from Bath & Body Works. So I don't even have to say too much about it because y'all already know what's up with that one. Another product that actually came as a shock and a surprise to me, and you guys know I do not even deal with this line of products from Bath & Body Works, that's the aromatherapy line, and I have absolutely been enjoying the Eucalyptus Experience Stress Relief line. So aromatherapy is just not my thing. I just do not buy their aromatherapy products because I just do not like smelling really earthy, herbal, and all of that. That's just not my thing, okay? But I ended up picking up these products like a couple of months ago, and I just recently started trying them out, and I have fell in love with them. These are staples in my collection now. So much so that I finished up a moisturizing body wash in this, and then this is my backup, and then I also bought some bath salt things during the body care day sale. So I have thoroughly been enjoying this. This is so good to help you wind down if you've had a long day. This is going to calm and relax you. This is good to use before you go to bed, but it's also good to use in the morning to kind of wake you up and get you energized. This definitely helps to clear your mind. Again, if you're feeling kind of stuffy and, you know, congested, this is going to open up your sinuses because of that spearmint. All around, this is just a good product, and I'm so mad that I was sleeping on it for so long. Like, I definitely will keep these as staples in my collection. Don't think I would touch any of the other things in the aromatherapy line, but that right there is now a staple. Okay, more body care products, things that I've already talked about in like shorts videos and community tab posts and things like that, so I'm not going to touch on them too long. Winter Candy Apple, this right here, I've been using it so much for the month of December. This has been my focus fragrance, and I'm getting through it really, really well because I like Winter Candy Apple. I think this is just such a pretty, loud, heavy, perfumey, cinnamon, rose, and apple type of scent. It's so, so perfumey. Literally, it smells like a perfume, you guys. I love how strong this is. This is definitely a winter tradition product for me. I always have to have it every year, and I'm glad that I have backups of this because I'm about to be done with this mist, and I still have more lotions and things like that to use with this. So I'm not going to miss it because I still have it, but Winter Candy Apple has definitely been a favorite, and I feel like December is just the perfect time to actually use it. A Thousand Christmas Wishes, another one that I feel December is the perfect time to use this fragrance going into New Year's and everything like that, because this is just a really bright, bubbly, Prosecco, berry type of scent. It's really pretty, really girly, really feminine. It will definitely carry you into nighttime. This packaging is stunning. So I've definitely been getting my use out of 1,000 Christmas Wishes, especially because I did my backups during body care day. So I've thoroughly been enjoying this one. And then Gingerbread Latte, y'all already know this is another fragrance that I was focusing on for December. This one is just so pretty. I was so happy to pull this out of my collection for the winter time because this, I don't know why they didn't bring this back, because this is actually really, really good. This is a great gourmand scent. It's sweet, it's soft, it's creamy, smells a little cookie-like, just very, very pretty. I'm glad I got a backup of this mist actually. Once I'm done with my shower gel and lotion, I'll only have a mist left, but that's okay because I do want to get through this fragrance. I don't want to try and hold on to things, but Gingerbread Latte is definitely good. This is definitely one that if you see at SAS, I highly recommend you get it and you try it. It's a great gourmand scent, great for the winter. It's just really, really nice to wear in the cold weather, so loving that. And then last for actual body care from Bath & Body Works, Pure Wonder. Pure Wonder has definitely grown on me a lot, and I think the main reason why I have been obsessing over Pure Wonder is because I mixed it with Valentino Donna Born in Roma one day, and that combination went together so well, you guys. I just smelled very luxurious and fancy and expensive. Like, that was a great combination together because they're both really perfumey type scents. Pure Wonder is definitely more of a classy, feminine, perfumey type of smell, and it's not soft, you guys. I thought this fragrance was so soft when I first got it. I was just like, it's not, you know, heavy hitter. It's not giving what it was supposed to have gave, child, until I wore it, and it gave what it was supposed to have gave. This scent is not weak at all. I'm sorry. Like, I know a lot of people were saying that, but when I put the shower gel, the lotion, and the spray together, and put Valentino on top, like, y'all, I was smelling up everything for hours, okay? Literal hours. They were so strong together, and that's the only reason why I have been loving Pure Wonder, because when I put it with Valentino, it just gives me, like, rich luxe vibes, period. So I definitely am going to get a backup of Pure Wonder. If this goes on sale for SAS, I am definitely going to get another set because I want to pair it with Valentino. So yeah, if you guys didn't see my community post pairing these together, now y'all know. Put these together and you will love it. Last body care item is actually the Cupcake Swirl from Body Fantasies. Y'all, I bought three of these little mini sprays because my Walmart did not have the big size, or at least I didn't see the big size. So I bought three of the mini so that I could have this scent around. This scent is so good. It's yummy. It's spicy. It's gourmand. It's long lasting. It's strong. This smells so good, and I love to pair it with a bunch of different things. Like, you could pair this with Joy Sugar Snickerdoodle, okay? You could pair this with Gingerbread Latte, okay? You could pair this with Winter Candy Apple. I know, but if y'all would have seen my layering video, Winter Candy Apple and Christmas Cookies goes really well together. Winter Candy Apple and Vanilla Bean Noel goes really well together, so it definitely goes together with Cupcake Swirl. This is also one you can pair with Vanilla Bean Noel. Like, there's so many different combinations and options that you have with this Body Fantasy spray. And do not sleep on Body Fantasies. Their sprays actually last quite a bit on the skin. This is my new favorite now. The vanilla, I've had to move the vanilla one to the side because this one is definitely my favorite now, and I'm glad that I have backups of it because it's definitely a staple. So before I get into the makeup, I'm going to talk to you guys about a few more staples that I've been loving. I have three perfumes here to show you guys, and I'm not going to talk too much about them because I've already mentioned them. So first is Ariana Grande's Cloud Intense. This has been one of my absolute favorite perfumes here recently. You guys know, just Cloud in general is just one of my favorite perfumes. Definitely top five. Like, it's one of my favorites. It's one that I wear so often, way more often than all of my other perfumes. Literally, you guys, I went through a 30 ml bottle of the original Cloud. I am halfway done with Cloud Intense, and I just repurchased another 30 ml bottle of the Cloud Original. Like, that's how much I love this fragrance. I will bounce around from the original to this one just because I love it so much. And I feel like this just does so much better in the winter and colder months. So I think when I originally bought Cloud the first time, I think I bought it at the beginning of the year, so it was still kind of winter, but it had started turning into spring already, and I didn't really get the full effect of it in like the cold weather. But this is amazing in cold weather, if I'm being completely honest. It's just so good. So Cloud Intense, like, this is just a favorite of mine, period. I don't need to put it in every favorites video because it's just like one of my all-time favorite perfumes. I think it is so nice. I think it is just very versatile. I think it's universal, all of those things. So definitely love that one. Definitely been loving Poison Girl Eau de Toilette. I talked about this perfume in my monthly perfume wrap-ups video, and basically this is just To me, this is a chocolate covered orange. It is so creamy, so good, gourmand, but it has some perfuminess to it from like the rose and the florals that's in the mid notes. And then, like I said, that orange is in the top note. So it's like a bright fruity blast. When you first spray it, this is just so good, so yummy. You guys can see how much of this I have used. I am still going to be filming my most used perfumes of the year video. This is definitely going in there because I bought this perfume. We're in December. I think I bought this perfume a week before my birthday, if I'm not mistaken, and look how much is already gone. So basically in less than a month, I've used a quarter of this perfume, and this is the 100 ml bottle. So that just lets you know that it's a favorite, most used. I love it, okay? And then the last perfume I have here is Paris Hilton Heiress. Now, this perfume is definitely one of my new favorites. Absolutely, positively. I wore this to work with Winter Peach Marshmallow. Combination right here. Here you guys go. I wore this to work with Winter Peach Marshmallow, and quite literally, you guys, quite literally, people were asking, what do I shower with? They was like, what? Like, what do you shower with? Because we need to know, because you smell good all the time. Like, you smell so nice. And that was because this just gives a really nice fresh and fruity combination. It's very clean smelling, but it's still very feminine and very girly, easy to reach for. It smells really, really good. And for whatever reason, even though these technically aren't like your standard winter fragrances, something about these together definitely does well in the cold winter air. So you guys need these, absolutely 100% Paris Hilton. I'm so glad I got the 100 ml of this. This was so cheap. This was like $25. I would definitely buy a backup of this bottle because I do not want to be without it. I do not want to be without it, okay? Okay, so now we're gonna move on to the makeup portion of this video, and I'm gonna try and keep it short and sweet. So first things first, foundation and concealer. I have absolutely fallen back in love with my Urban Decay Stay Naked foundation and concealer. These products are just gold for me. The Urban Decay Stay Naked, you put it on, it dries down so fast on your skin, but it gives you a really nice coverage. It's not going anywhere, it's not budging. When it says stay, it's going to stay on your skin, okay? But it does look very skin-like. It does give you that like naked feel. But this is definitely transfer resistant. This is definitely water resistant and all of that. I remember the first time I tried this foundation out, I had got caught in the rain and I had little water droplets on my face. But when I patted them away, my foundation was not lifting up in the spots where I had patted the water off. So this foundation is definitely heavy duty. It's mask proof. You guys definitely need this. And I am so glad that I rediscovered it back in my collection. I'm so happy to be getting back into my collection and playing around with things. The concealer is definitely heavy duty. It's definitely a fuller coverage concealer, but it's a thin, almost kind of liquidy formula, but it definitely dries down fast just like the foundation. Highly recommend this combo if you have oily skin or if you're trying not to have transfer in your mask or anything like that. I recommend both of those products. The next product is going to be my NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop Mattifying Powder. This is in the shade Mocha. This is the only powder that I have been wanting to use. I love the effect that this powder gives to my skin. I'm wearing it today. I feel like it makes my skin look just so flawless, luxurious. It doesn't make it look powdery, but it makes it look skin-like. And it's just, I'm obsessed. This is an obsession, okay? And to think I really wasn't about to pick up this powder, but I'm so, so glad I did because now I can't be without it. This is definitely a staple in my collection. The next thing is going to be my bronzer. Now, this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Powder Bronzer in Mahogany. I've had this bronzer for a while, but I have recently fallen in love with it. I love the color of it. I love the formula, and I love applying it with this particular brush. This is the Morphe R14 brush. It just gives me the perfect bronze to my skin. If you guys can see that, like, it just really gives the perfect bronze to my skin. It just applies the bronzer in the perfect spot. This brush is super duper soft. I just love it. So I've definitely been loving this combination for my bronzer. And then for cream products, this is the Huda Beauty Medium Tantour Contour and Bronzer Cream. Absolutely been loving this. I showed you guys this in my holiday get ready with me. I've been using the crap out of this. I absolutely love it. When I run out of this, because I know I'm going to run out of this because I use it so often, I would definitely repurchase it. This product is gold, okay? Another concealer I want to mention, this is the one that I'm wearing under my eyes today. This is the One Size Beauty Turn Up the Base Butter Silk Concealer. Love this. Love the effect that it gives on my skin. This concealer dries down really fast though. I'm not even gonna lie. This concealer dries down really fast. It gives a nice coverage under the eyes though, and I love the way that it makes my skin look. When it says butter silk, it really does look like silk under the eye. So when I put powder on top of it, the powder doesn't stick to it or anything like that. It just really looks nice under the eyes, and I like how it transfers on camera. So I have the shade medium dark 3, and this is perfect for me to highlight under my eyes. It gives me the color that I want and everything, and it just looks stunning. So been loving that concealer. For eyeshadow palettes, I have two to mention to you guys. One of them I used in my Glam Holiday Makeup tutorial. This is the Lorac Fairy Tale Forest eyeshadow palette. It has the most gorgeous colors in here. And like I told you guys in that tutorial, this is a great palette to take you from Christmas to New Year's, all the way to Valentine's Day, to any holiday, any special occasion that you have. You have your lighter shades in here for your lid, and then you have your darker, more jewel tone colors in here. So it's great to transition you all the way into like spring and summer. I just really like this palette. I love the fact that the shimmers in here have a lot of shift to them, a lot of shimmer and glimmer, because you know that's my thing, that's right up my alley. So this palette is definitely really, really nice to have. Oh, and the mattes blend, really, really nice as well. And then my Too Faced Gingerbread Spice palette. This is a palette that I always pull out during the holidays because I just love when they came out with these little tin palettes for the holidays, like representing Thanksgiving and Christmas and all of that. I just fell in love with these. So this is the OG, and I just still love this palette to this day. This shade right here is still my favorite in the palette. This is absolutely stunning, like 100%. I don't think I would ever get over this palette. No matter how old it gets, I want it in my collection because it is just so pretty. The last couple of things that I want to mention to you guys, these Maybelline bronze glosses. If you haven't gotten your hands on the Maybelline lifter glosses, period, what are you doing? Okay, because they had the first set of glosses that came out at Ulta and Target and Walmart, and then they had the CVS exclusive shades that came out, and now they have this bronze collection. I have all of them because these glosses are absolutely amazing. Matter of fact, I was just wearing one yesterday. I was wearing the 001 pearl shade yesterday, and you guys can see I'm pretty much almost done with this gloss. Like, I literally only have that bottom half left because these glosses are just so good. They're so hydrating on the lips. They make your lips look healthy and juicy. Some of them have shimmer, some of them are creams. The bronze ones are just stunning. These are stunning. I was wearing one of them in my last holiday video. The colors are absolutely gorgeous, brown skin friendly, so you need it. Okay, you need those. Ooh, I thought I was done, y'all. I got a couple more things. Oh my god. Okay, so another lip product that I want to talk about, this is the CO Bigelow Vanilla Mint Supreme 2x lip moisturizer. Again, mentioned this in my winter body care essentials video. If you don't have this, you absolutely need it. It gives a nice cooling sensation to the lips because of the mint in this, and it also freshens your breath. What other lip gloss you got that does that? Okay, this is going to make your breath smell fresh, and it really does work. I'm letting y'all know it really does work, and this really does moisturize your lips, and it gives a nice glossy shine. So 100% recommend this and love that. These socks, y'all, these socks that came in the Thanksgiving box, I had them on last night. Absolutely love them. Okay, I've been wearing them pretty much every night to bed just because, like I said, I haven't been feeling the best. So I love to put that Twisted Peppermint Cloud Butter on my feet and then put these socks on because they are infused with shea, so they keep your feet soft and moisturized and nice at night. And I just like the cooling sensation that I get from the cloud butter inside of those socks. The last thing I'm going to mention is just a little accessory item. This is my ColourPop x Barbie little mirror. I've been using this here recently to like do my makeup and stuff, regardless of whether I'm filming a tutorial or I'm just doing my makeup to film other videos. I have been loving using this little mirror. It's so tiny, but it's so perfect. I can still see my entire face in this mirror, and I just love it. I have been absolutely obsessed with using this to just do my makeup. You guys know I'm obsessed with handheld mirrors. Like, I have so many handheld mirrors just sitting up here because, like I said, I'm obsessed. Okay, like, I'm obsessed. How many more handheld mirrors do I need? But love that one. And that is everything, you guys. Those are all the things that I have been enjoying, all of my winter favorites. Like, so many things, I know. That's why I said I had to do a part two to this video. But that's everything, you guys. I hope y'all enjoyed this video and hearing my thoughts on all of these products and what has been my favorite. You guys already know. Leave me a comment down below letting me know what you have enjoyed. If you've been enjoying any of these products, or if you've been enjoying other products that I need to know about, just go ahead and let me know down in the comments. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. If you're new, sis, thank you so much for watching. Definitely go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Join the Fragrance and Beauty Army, as well as that bell notification, so that you can be notified every single time that I upload a video. And I will see you guys in my next one. Peace.